I wanted to upload a video with a few ideas I thought people might want to experiment with. I posted a photo of kind of a weird looking wrap I did purely by accident when I was trying some variations on tiger wraps. I kind of thought to myself, why not use the color of the blank as one of the colors in your wrap? I laid down the bottom wrap like you would for a two thread top wrap if you're making a tiger wrap, and I wrapped from my left hand side to my right hand side using 40 weight embroidery thread that's a little smaller in diameter than size A rod wrapping thread. I used two threads to make the bottom layer, and then I removed the second thread that was a sacrificial thread from the wrap, which left the blue colored thread you see and the white blank, which made my second color of the base layer. I burnished the remaining blue thread in different directions like you would do on a normal bottom wrap of a tiger wrap. Then I wrapped over the threads in the opposite direction from my right hand side to my left hand side using 20 pound test clear monofilament. I was pretty happy with the unusual looking wrap that started appearing as I wrapped the mono over the base layer, and as you can see, the mono's lens created a neat optical illusion of squiggly thicker bands and also very thin vertical bands. This is a pretty interesting looking pattern. It looks much more complex than it really is. I liked it, so I decided to do the bottom layer of another test wrap using two different colors, blue and yellow. The thin 40 weight embroidery thread in blue and yellow looks pretty neat as it is. They seem to blend together and create a green colored wrap, and it's kind of a neat looking old school look to it that I like personally. But I went ahead and burnished this bottom layer in opposite directions, and then I added some 20 pound monofilament over the top of the wrap in the opposite direction, and it created this almost cartoonish looking wrap that made me think of Dory from Finding Nemo. It kind of reminds me, I guess, the colors of the fish in Finding Nemo. The drawback to doing this kind of a semi-tigerish wrap like this is dealing with the monofilament itself. It adds quite a bit of thickness to the wrap, but it makes a pretty strong magnification of the very thin thread that was used to do the bottom wrap. I've also been playing around with invisible wraps. I mostly use light and ultralight rods, and I thought invisible guide wraps would look pretty cool on those types of rods. I had some invisible thread that's made out of polyester, and it's made by Coates and Clark. I already had that stuff at home, so I decided to experiment with it. You can find this invisible thread almost anywhere that carries sewing supplies. Walmart, craft stores, places like that. I know silk is the go-to thread for transparent wraps. I don't have any. I'm going to get some, but I don't have any at the moment. So I wanted to try this transparent polyester thread and see what I could do with it. And I already had it on hand. I found out pretty quick that it looks splotchy after you put epoxy on it. I figured the reason for this is because there's a combination of transparent and translucent effects when you apply the epoxy. It looked to me like the reason for that is that the epoxy can't completely penetrate and surround the polyester monofilament type of a thread. My workaround for that was to put an underwrap of thread down on the blank itself and then put the guide foot on top of that and then wrap the guide on with the transparent thread. I was thinking here that the underwrap would soak up the epoxy, and that would make it easier for it to surround the invisible polyester thread better. This helped a lot, and I was able to move the polyester threads around just a little bit with a sewing needle in the areas where the epoxy still wasn't getting to, and that really worked well, and it made the wrap pretty close to being completely transparent. If you look closely, you can still see the clear polyester thread on the guide foot, but it's really hard to see it at all on the rest of the wrap. I made some of these invisible wraps with some metallic thread, and I used it to make it look like a thin wire that was holding the guide onto the blank itself. And I really like this look a lot. It's pretty decorative. So I plan on getting some silk thread that's recommended for transparent wraps at some point and give this another shot. If you want to try the clear polyester thread, it works best if you leave small gaps in the wrap as you go. Don't pack it super tight. It allows the epoxy some room to get in there and work its way into those gaps. I hope this gives y'all some ideas you might want to play around with. If you make any discoveries messing with these ideas, please leave them in the comments below so myself or others can try it. And that's all I've got for now, y'all. Take care.